Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And welcome to the celebration of our Mass on this beautiful Sunday morning. We gather together and we are continuing to celebrate Easter. Last weekend was Easter Sunday. Today is the second Sunday of Easter, and we are continuing to celebrate the resurrection of our Lord Jesus from the dead. Today is also Divine Mercy Sunday, which is when we celebrate the wonderful devotion to the Divine Mercy, which was given to Sister Faustina, a saint from Poland. And we have some of her relics placed upon our altar on this day. So today is a day of great celebration in the church throughout the world. And in our Mass today, we have a very special celebration. During our Mass today, George will be baptized. He will become a Catholic, and it's with great joy that we welcome George and all your family and friends here to church today, as we, in the midst of this Mass, will celebrate your baptism. We come to pray for all who need our prayers. We pray for the sick, the bereaved and grieving. We pray for peace in the troubled areas of our world, which certainly need our prayers. We ask the Lord to forgive us for the times when we have sinned. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty, mighty Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of God. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of God.
Mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast kindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The whole group of believers was united, heart and soul. No one claimed for his own use anything he had, as everything they owned was held in common. The apostles continued to testify to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus with great power, and they were all given great respect. None of their members was ever in want, as all those who owned land or houses would sell them and bring the money to them, present it to the apostles. It was then distributed to any members who might be in need. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response is, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his love has no end.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his love has no end.
Let the sons of Israel say, his love has no end. Let the sons of Aaron say, his love has no end. Let those who fear the Lord say, his love has no end.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his love has no end.
The Lord's right hand has triumphed. His right hand raised me up. I shall not die, I shall live and recount his deeds. I was punished by the Lord, but not doomed to die.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, his love has no end.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. This is the work of the Lord, a marvel in our eyes. This day was made by the Lord. We rejoice and are glad.
For his love has helped me.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Whoever believes that Jesus is the Christ has been begotten by God, And whoever loves the Father that begot him loves the child whom he begets. We can be sure that we love God's children if we love God himself and do what he has commanded us. This is what loving God is, keeping his commandments. And his commandments are not difficult, because anyone who has been begotten by God has already overcome the world. This is the victory over the world, our faith. Who can overcome the world? Only the man who believes that Jesus is the Son of God. Jesus Christ, who came by water and blood, not with water only, but with water and blood, with the Spirit as another witness, since the Spirit is the truth. The word of the Lord. Alleluia. 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 Jesus said, "You believe because you can see me. Happy are those who have not seen and yet believe."
Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the evening of that same day, the first day of the week, the doors were closed in the room where the disciples were for fear of the Jews. Jesus came and stood among them. He said to them, "Peace be with you," and showed them his hands and his side. The disciples were filled with joy when they saw the Lord, and he said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father sent me, so am I sending you." After saying this, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. For those whose sins you forgive, they are forgiven. For those whose sins you retain, they are retained." Thomas, called the twin, who was one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. When the disciples said, "We have seen the Lord," he answered, "Unless I see the holes that the nails made in his hands, and can put my finger into the holes they made, and unless I can put my hand into his side, I refuse to believe." 8 days later, the disciples were in the house again, and Thomas was with them. The doors were closed, but Jesus came in and stood among them. "Peace be with you," he said. Then he spoke to Thomas, "Put your finger here. Look, here are my hands. Give me your hand. Put it into my side. Doubt no longer, but believe." Thomas replied, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "You believe because you can see me. Happy are those who have not seen and yet believe." There were many other signs that Jesus worked and the disciples saw, but they are not recorded in this book. These are recorded so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing this, you may have life through his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In a few minutes' time, something very wonderful is going to take place. We will celebrate the sacrament of baptism for George. And I just want to explain to everyone in church the things that will happen. First of all, I say a special prayer, an anointed sacred oil before the baptism, praying that George will be strengthened by God against the things in this world that are not good, things we call evil. So it's a prayer of strengthening before baptism. And then through his own free will with parents and godparents and family with him, he'll make what we call the baptism promises, the declaration that he has faith. And then we go over to the font, over there, for the baptism. And then once the baptism has taken place, there will be another anointing with sacred oil, the oil of chrism, blessed by the bishop just a couple of weeks ago at the chrism mass. And this is a sign that through having been baptized, we believe he's been touched by God in a wonderful way. And then after that, a baptism candle is lit from this Easter candle as a reminder that the faith in which he has been baptized is an Easter faith, a faith in the resurrection. There's no homily today. The baptism is the homily itself. But I invite everyone, as we do these things, please pray for him. We all need prayers. To be a Christian in our world today is sometimes a challenge, not always easy. So as these elements of the sacrament unfold, please keep this young man in your prayers.
Almighty and heavenly God, who sent your Son into the world, cast out the power of Satan through his kingdom, as commanded the feet of the darkness, bring with us another of the light. We pray this child that you feel from the Holy Ghost, take the example of your call, that your Holy Spirit, come with you, cast in the Lord Christ. We worship you, the Father of salvation. In the name of Christ our Savior, may he strengthen you in his power. As we pray for the Lord. Thank you. Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. And the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the Father of your new birth, and the Father of the Holy Spirit, of the Holy Spirit, of the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit, of the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit, of Christ is the one of the Holy Spirit, of the Holy Spirit, so may you live always, as a member of his body, sharing the everlasting life. Amen. Lord, you have clothed yourself with the good new creation, clothed yourself in this white cloud, we have the sign of the Holy Spirit. With your family and friends, help you by the word of the Son. Bring that liberty of the Spirit, the everlasting life. Receive the light of Christ. Heavens and God heavens. This light is an entrustment to you as a learning Christ. This child of God's in the light of my eyes. He is more always as a child of the light. May he keep the flame of faith alive in his heart. When the Lord comes, he grows his meat. All saints in the heavenly kingdom. We may us prayer.
So that is wonderful and beautiful, and can I just say to George, what you're doing today gives us all a boost. The fact that you have chosen through your own free will to be baptized, to join the Catholic Church, in all that surrounds us in our world, is a great witness. So congratulations. As a family, as friends, you should be so proud of him. Anyway, we continue our Mass now by praying the Creed. It's given on the bulletin, the shorter Creed. If you'd like to please stand and pray the Creed together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. As we share the joy of the Lord's death, we present to our Saviour all our needs.
We pray for Pope Francis and Bishop Ralph. May they be blessed and filled with the graces that they need for their ministry. Lord, hear mercy. We pray for people who are bereaved and feeling the pain of losing a loved one. May they have a constant awareness of the kingdom of heaven. Lord, hear mercy. We pray for our children who are preparing to receive the sacrament of the Eucharist. Throughout their lives, may they always have a sense of the presence of God. Lord, hear mercy. We ask for God's blessings upon all those who have been baptized this Easter. May they be filled with God's graces. Lord, hear mercy. We pray for all those who are engaged to be married, and especially those couples who are to be married here this year. Grant them a deep love for each other that will sustain them throughout their lives. And may they always be aware of God's love for them. Lord, hear mercy. We ask for the intercession of Our Lady, the Queen of Peace, as we say.
Amen.
The Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, and at the hour of our death. Let us pray for a moment in silence.
Father in heaven, as we now present our gifts at your altar, we pray for your blessing and ask that our lives be continually inspired by the gospel message. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept your sacrifice and the good of all His
will. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people and of those who are brought to new birth, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Give them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb, who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people, exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis our Pope, and Ralph our Bishop, and all those who hold into the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you also for those whom you have been pleased to give the new birth of water and the Holy Spirit, granting them forgiveness of all their sins. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant, Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest, Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, open your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints. Admit as we beseech you into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us share with each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be. Bring your hand and feel the place of the nails, and do not be unbelieving, but believing. Alleluia.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please take a bulletin for all the notices for the coming week. And just to say that tomorrow is a very special solemnity. It's the Annunciation. The Annunciation normally takes place on the 25th of March, but that was in Holy Week this year. So it's been moved, and tomorrow is when the church celebrates the Annunciation. So Mass tomorrow is at 7 p.m. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go glorifying the Lord by your life. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. And finally to George, once again, congratulations. Lots of good things ahead with confirmation and Holy Communion very soon as well. And to your family, celebrate this day. Be very proud. God bless.
Thank you.